In this video, we will talk how to smooth a given plot in origin. For example, we are having a UV-based plot and we would like to smooth it. If it is having some oscillations, then we can smooth it very easily in origin. Let's have a look. This is a two column plot, the UV-based plot. This is the x-axis on which we are having wavelength and this is the intensity. And here we can see the plot that it is a decaying plot but having some oscillations, and these oscillations has nothing to do with the experiment, with some machine problem, etc. Select the plot and then go to analysis, and in signal processing go to smooth and open dialog. Now as we open dialog, then a box will appear, and here the very first thing we will have to do to enable the auto preview. And as I enable auto preview, then it is showing me the whole plot. So I will have to zoom that portion, and the portion is from 500 to 700 and up to 4. So let's zoom out that portion here. That this is the zoom tool, and we will have to start from very low values here, from 500 to 700. And here it is. Now the value is here is 10, so we will have to consider up to 4. So again, the zooming tool here, and we want to have the value from here to here, for example. And now we can see that our plot is actually the black one, but the red one, which is the smooth plot, is overlapping it. So we will have to just see this thing. Let me increase the size of this one. Okay, now we can play with the parameters here. The very first thing we have here is the method, which is Savitzky-Golay method. And another method we are having the adjacent averaging, and this is the Savitzky method. So we will go on with the Savitzky method. And points of windows means that as we increase the point, the smoothing will become more smooth and all these peaks will be ignored. While inside the polynomial order, we can change the polynomial order. We can go to many order, but we will keep here a 2. And let's increase this one from 5 to 10, and we can see that there is some effect on the one. The black one is slightly shown on the background. So increase this one to 20, click somewhere, and now we can see very clearly here that the black is appearing and the red one is just going in middle of it. So increasing it more up to 30, and now we can see that it anywhere this black is appearing. Now the oscillations are there. So move to 40, and you can see here as I give the value, then this has shown some smoothing of the profile. So this way we have removed the oscillations. While over here, if we are fitting this thing with the exponential, then we will lose this kind of broad peak here, which may be experimental. But these oscillations, they are not experimental, and we can smooth them out. And here we have done that with this method, 40, and this we have smoothed this profile. And let me click OK. Now the portion that I'm interested here will be here, and this one is the smooth data. I can now plot the two data here. And let me go to the zoomed portion that I was interested in, and it is somehow here. And let me further go to the data here. and here it is. Now I can just do some makeup to it. First click this one to remove the extra legend, and now here this is the smooth one and this one is the actual. So I just go in, increase the width of it, and let's say I give it 10. So apply. Okay, they were both here, so I will have to make them independent. And now I go here and to this one I give 10, while to this one I give, let's say, 3 here, and I do apply. And now it is clearly evident that the smoothing here is just going at the middle of this one, and our profile has been made smooth. Let's we have another plot, and the plot is of PL, for example, and it also requires some smoothing. Now here in this plot, let me zoom it a bit more. Now here, as I can see, that these oscillations, they have nothing to do with the experiment, while this broad peak is experimental. Similarly, this is an experimental peak, and these are not related to any experimental. So I will select this one, I will go to analysis, then to signal processing, and then to smooth, and I will have to preview it first. So to go to the zoom portion, I will have to take from 500 to 850 and up to 3. So from 500 to 800, and now it is a bit evident. So from 3 we will have to start, and we will have to stop here. Okay, and now this is our profile. The data is actually, the black is the data and the red is the smoothing of it, but for the moment is we haven't changed the parameters with this method, and with the 5 window points we are having almost the same plot. And now let's zoom it a bit more in order to be more clear about this. And now here it is. So let me change this one to 15, and you can see that after a while it changed the smoothing. Let's move to 30, and now I can see that on 30 I'm having this thing, this peak is there, while these have been removed. So I can go to another value, let's say 40, and with 40 I am having almost the smooth profile of this. And this way we can smooth this thing. If I want to check the other methods, for example the adjacent averaging, which takes 2 points and average them, I can see here that this one is more perfect here compared to the Savitzky method at the 40 points windows. So I can go on by keeping this one instead of the other. So this way we can smooth our plot very easily. We will have to check that what kind of method is good for our plot, because for some plots one method will be good, while for the other will be fine.